Hello, Cloud Gurus. I'm Nigel Poulton, author of the Kubernetes Deep Dive video course here on A Cloud Guru, and welcome to Kubernetes This Month. As always, I hope that you're all safe and well. So, we'll start out with a roundup of the major news from the Kubernetes and cloud native space. We'll pick a couple of the more interesting items and dive a bit deeper, and then we'll finish things up with your chance to test your Kubernetes knowledge with a brand new Guru of the Month question. So, grab a comfy seat and maybe a drink, and let's find out what's been going down in the world of Kubernetes. First up this month, Mirantis just released Docker Enterprise 3.1. So, congratulations to the team there, and we'll take a closer look at that in the deeper dive section. Over into the hosted Kubernetes space, Azure Kubernetes Service, AKS, has Kubernetes 1.18 versions available in preview. Have some of that. Linode announced general availability of LKE, their hosted Linode Kubernetes Engine, and honestly, I've had a good play around with it, and it is probably the simplest hosted Kubernetes I have ever seen. Congratulations, Linode. Switching focus to security, Google Kubernetes Engine GKE has moved container threat detection into beta. Now, at a high level, this watches for common runtime attacks, and it reports them up through the native tooling like Security Command Center and Cloud Logging. StackRox, they've announced new runtime security features in their StackRox Kubernetes Security Platform. Things like container-specific federal information systems checks, such as NIST SP800-53. Docker Desktop is now GA on Windows 10 with the WSL2 subsystem. Now, this is great if you're a Windows laptop user and you're working with Linux containers, because WSL, the Windows subsystem for Linux, allows for faster Linux containers, and it means you can now run Docker Desktop on Windows 10 Home Edition, and loads of people are gonna love that. Out into the wider ecosystem now, and Istio released version 1.6 with simplify, simplify, simplify as the tagline. Now, the overall architecture is simpler, with Istio D now doing away with Citadel, Gallery, and the sidecar injector. Plus, there's easier upgrades and even canaried control plane upgrades, which I love the idea of. Harbor, the OCI compliant registry for more than just container images, released version 2.0, so congratulations there. The CNCF released a commissioned report on the state of cloud native development. Now, I quite like skimming through reports like this, and if you've got a few minutes, I definitely recommend it's worth a skim. And I think rounding up the news for this month, the CNCF again has announced this time that Dan Cohn, the longtime leader of the CNCF, has stepped down and will be replaced by Priyanka Sharma, who will be general manager. Now, Dan's moving on to a new role in the Linux Foundation, and I'd like to thank him for everything that he did. And of course, I'd like to wish Priyanka all the best in her new role at the top of the CNCF. And that, Gurus, wraps the news for this month. Let's take a deeper dive into Docker Enterprise 3.1 and the security stuff that we're about to see with the Docker and Snyk partnership. Okay, look, this is a show about Kubernetes, so why so much Docker? Well, on this particular topic, Docker Enterprise, it is an enterprise-grade Kubernetes platform. And this 3.1 release is the first since Mirantis acquired the technology from Docker Inc. So I think it can potentially tell us a lot about what we can expect in the future from Mirantis. Well, first up with this release, it supports Kubernetes 1.17. And when you consider that 1.18 is pretty much still warm from the press, 1.17 is decently up to date for an enterprise-grade platform. There's also support for Windows Server 2019 nodes, meaning, of course, as well, support for Windows apps. There's better support for GPUs, so that includes easier scheduling to GPU nodes, plus easier implementation of GPU-related policies. There's simplified installation of the Istio service mesh with sensible out-of-the-box defaults. And importantly, I think for any platform claiming or aiming to be enterprise-grade, there's improved SLAs for mission-critical apps. Not bad in my book. Okay, more on Docker again, and this time on the security front. So, I'm including these updates in the deeper dive section because a lot of us use Docker Desktop and Docker Hub. In fact, I got a new computer the other day and pretty much the first thing I installed when I flipped the power on was Docker Desktop. Well, anyway, apparently the single most requested feature people have been asking for from Docker is integrated scanning. Well, this partnership with Snyk will definitely bring that. We should expect to see Docker Desktop and Docker Hub both offering integrated vulnerability scanning of images plus suggested remediations. And the whole idea with this, right, is that you don't have to be anything even approaching a security expert to be able to work with it and leverage its power. Now, another interesting feature should be the ability for Snyk to analyze your packages, recommend official Docker base images, and then even notify you when Docker releases updates to those base images. You know, because maybe you might need some fixes that are included. Now look, it's early days, but I think all in all, it's a great thing. I mean, it's hard not to like something that's integrating simple to use security. And that wraps our deeper dive section. Okay, Guru of the Month. Last month we asked which native Kubernetes technology you'd use to enforce a cluster-wide policy to block privileged containers from a cluster. And the correct answer was A, enable the PSP admission controller and create a pod security policy. And oh my goodness, we had some top quality answers. In fact, I scribbled a few of my own notes while I was reading through some of them. Anyway, look, there can only be one winner, and this month it's Borko Jerkovic. Now, Borko is a cloud solutions architect from Ottawa in Ontario, Canada, and he's going to be getting a goodie bag in the post from us. Now, I've said this before, right, but I really appreciate all the responses, and the detail that some of you go into is just magic. Actually, I feel bad that we can't pick more winners, but the rules are the rules, and Borko is our winner this month. Thanks to everyone else, though. This month's brand new question is in the forum link below, so you go ahead and test your knowledge this month. And then as always, I hope to see you all again next month. Same cube time, same cube place.